A very good afternoon, students. I'm Anamika Bhau, your English teacher. Welcome you all to the online English classes. So students, last week we discussed the chapter 2 of a supplementary reader snapshot, that is the address by Maga Minko. I hope the chapter is clear to all of you. So students, today again we are going to have a little introduction about the chapter, about the theme of the chapter, the main characters of the chapter, and after that we are going to discuss the question answers, which contains textual questions plus extra questions. But before that, let's have a recap of the chapter to answer the questions in a better way. So let's move on. The address by Maga Minko. So this is an autobiographical account. This is the story of Maga Minko herself, who was a Dutch journalist. The original name is Sarah Minko. She was from Holland. She had seen the Second World War from very near and lost her parents and property in the Second World War. So that's why in the present story of the address, she has depicted that loss of the parents and the property during the war. So the main theme of the chapter is human predicament that follows the war. The main characters of the story, first is Maga Minko, who is the narrator. Second is Mrs. Darling, who was the former neighbor of Maga Minko. And third is Mrs. S, the mother of the narrator. So these are the three characters around which the story revolves. So the main theme of the story is human predicament that follows war, that is post-war human predicament. So this story tells us about the feelings of the people after the war. The story is about the girl, about Maga Minko herself, who lost her mother and the property in the war, and afterwards how she manages to live in this hostile world. What are the hurdles, what are the struggles she went through? This story contains all the things here. So this story starts with when Maga Minko, the narrator herself, knocks at the door of a house, and a lady named Mrs. Darling opened the door, but the lady refuses to recognize the girl. And after that, Maga Minko, the narrator, was thinking that maybe she came at the wrong address. But afterwards, when she notices that the lady, Mrs. Darling, was wearing the green knitted sweater of her mother, she realizes that she is at the correct address. But she was shocked and was not able to understand that why Mrs. Darling refuses to recognize her. And after that, she came back from the house because the lady refuses to talk to her and told her to go back. And the narrator is coming back, and on the way back, she even saw the nameplate outside the house, which states Mrs. Darling, house number 46, Marconi Street. So she came back, and on the way back to the railway station, she was encountered with all the memories of the mother, all the old memories, and she was recalling the address which has been given to her by her mother before the war. So she was recalling the address, that whether that was the right address or not. So she was recalling the incident when the mother of the narrator gave her the address. She recalled that one day when she was at home after the school, she notices that some things are missing from the house. So she was inquiring from the mother that where are our things, why the house is looking empty. So at that time she met Mrs. Darling. And at that time Mrs. Darling was taking a heavy suitcase from the house, and the girl is just inquiring from the mother that why Mrs. Darling every time comes and goes with lot of things, and this time she is going with a heavy suitcase, and why the house is looking so empty. So the mother is saying that I am giving all the things to Mrs. Darling to keep them safe. because as you know that this is the war time going on every time, and anytime we have to go back from the house, we have to run from the house. So I'm keeping all the things safe and I'm giving all the things to Mrs. Darling to keep them safe. But the girl was not satisfied, but the girl was not agreed with the mother. She told the mother not to give the things to Mrs. Darling because the narrator saw the fleeting smile on the face of Mrs. Darling at that time. And she knew that Mrs. Darling is not going to give back all the things back. So she don't have any trust on Mrs. Darling. She refused the mother to give all the things to Mrs. Darling, but since still the mother gave all the things to Mrs. Darling, and afterwards the mother gave the address to the narrator that if you have to take back all the things back, you can go to that address after the war and get the things back. At that time the mother gave the address to the narrator, and that address was house number 46, Marconi Street, Holland. So the girl recalled that this is the correct address which my mother gave me before the war, but she was not able to understand that why the lady refused to talk to her and refused to recognize her. So she decided to go to the house for the second time. When she went for the second time, Mrs. Darling was not at house, and the daughter of Mrs. Darling, who was 15 years old, she opened the door and let the narrator inside. And when the narrator, Maga Minko, went inside the home, when she sat in the living room, she was encountered with all the familiar things around. So all the memories, all the sad memories of the death of the mother revived back in the mind of the narrator. But she was very sad looking the condition of the things. The furniture was very ugly, giving a foul smell. The things were not in a good condition. So the narrator thinks that these all things have lost the meanings, because these things are not with the persons which they were linked to. So that's why that things have lost their meanings, and they were at a very bad condition. So all the things have lost the meanings for the narrator, and afterwards she decided not to take anything with her, and she came back from the house. And on the way back, again she saw the nameplate which states the correct address given by the mother to the narrator. But at last she resolves not to take anything with her, because all the things reminds her of the sad memories of the death of the mother, and also that things had lost the value. So she resolves not to take anything with her, and she came back to the house where she was living in a small rented room. So this is the story about, which tells us about the human conditions after the war, post-war human predicament. So this is the story about, students. Go through the whole of the story. Have a thorough reading of the story. And in case of any doubts, please ask me. And now let's go on to discuss the question answers. Firstly, we will discuss the short answer questions. Our first question is, where had the narrator come from? Why was she back? So from the story, it is apparent that this is an autobiographical account of Maga Minko herself. And she was a Dutch Jew who had to leave Holland during the Second World War. But she is the only one back. Can point out to the fact that the narrator and her family must have been taken to the concentration camps, and thus Mrs. Darling's remarks, "I thought no one had come back." The narrator, like the author, must have escaped from the address. And why she was back? She was now back because she was curious to touch and feel their old things which were given to Mrs. Darling, her mother's old acquaintance, for safekeeping the things during the Second World War. Second question is, whom did the narrator desire to meet in Holland and why? The narrator was back in Holland to her old neighborhood from where she was deported during the Second World War. She had gone to Mrs. Darling, who had volunteered to safekeep all the stuff during the war, and the narrator's mother had asked her to remember Mrs. Darling's address, house number 46, Marconi Street. So that's why the narrator desired to meet Mrs. Darling in Holland, as the mother told her to meet Mrs. Darling after the war to get all the things back. She came to meet her, Mrs. Darling, in order to look at the old things of the past life, at a very least, if not retrieve them. Okay, so our third question is, why did the narrator return to Marconi Street after a long time? So she took a long time to come back to get the things back, because as the war conditions going on, after the war, it was not easy for the girl to settle in the world. But afterwards, she was able to manage and got a small rented room and was living and settled her life a bit. She was not interested at first in all the stored stuff, afraid that they might bring back memories of the people who no longer existed. Their existence would bring out the contrast between the narrator's past normal life and her present uprooted predicament. How did the narrator decide to go back to the things? The narrator had long avoided going back to the old neighborhood to get the old things back, because post-liberation, after the war, life was not problem-free. But as gradually she was able to purchase a bed of lighter color and sleep in a bed without being threatened, and her surrounding turned less hostile and her life settled a bit. And when the life settled a bit, then she decided, and then she felt curious to know about the things of the mother. And since the things were also a part of her earlier simple life, and she liked to visit that life yet again. So this is it. Question number 5. Explain, I was horrified. I was in a room I knew, I didn't know. So this line is being said by Maga Minko, the narrator herself, when she went inside the house of Mrs. Darling, and when she encountered all the things around, she was horrified. When she entered Mrs. Darling's living room, the room had all the things which her house once had, but now these all the things were in this strange place of Mrs. Darling's house, and also they were arranged in a very tasteless manner. So all the things brought back haunting memories of the past to oppress her, and didn't succeed in making the narrator find her previous normal self, as the things were in a very bad condition. So that's why she was horrified and said that I was in a room I knew and didn't know. Question number 6. Why did the narrator didn't want to remember the place? She had decided not to remember her address anymore, for it was of no use anymore. And the conditions and the things have lost the value. So that's why she decided not to remember the place again. Because instead of giving pleasant memories, she was welcomed there, and the memories that she went to recall oppressed and horrified her. The things no longer had the same value without the people to whom they were linked to. So it was better that she forgets them and moves on with her life. So these are the short answer type questions, students. Let's go on to discuss the long answers and the textual questions. Describe the narrator's first post-war meeting with Mrs. Darling. As you all know, when she went to the Mrs. Darling's house and Mrs. Darling opened the door, She refuses to recognize the girl, and girl was thinking that probably she came to the wrong address. But after she notices that the Mrs. Darling is wearing the green knitted sweater of the mother, she realizes that she is at the correct address. Mrs. Darling practically hid herself behind the door and made sure that the narrator didn't see what was inside. That she was ensuring it that the narrator would not see that thing, the things inside, that all the things belongs to her only. Next is contrast the characters of the narrator's mother and Mrs. Darling. As we all know, Mrs. Darling was a very fleeting lady, and Mrs. S was a very simple and trusting woman. So they both, Mrs. S and Mrs. Darling, were both old acquaintances. Mrs. Darling had renewed the contact with the mother of the narrator and voluntarily asked to safekeep Mrs. S things at her home. The reason that Mrs. Darling gave was that if people came to take her away, it would be a shame that all those pretty things in her should be destroyed. So Mrs. Darling wants to take all the things with her to safekeep the things. Mrs. S was a very trusting and simple woman who was very gullible, and as a result didn't see the malice behind Mrs. Darling's intentions. She was instead concerned that how much risk Mrs. Darling is taking, that she lugged out a huge suitcase from their house every time she visits. Mrs. S genuinely believed that Mrs. Darling was helping them. And when everything was over, she would return everything. But on the contrary, Mrs. Darling was aware of the ongoing politics and knew that probably no one from Mrs. S family would survive to claim these things again. And she used to keep them as her own. So Mrs. S and Mrs. Darling represent two visions through which the war was viewed. The hopeful and hopeless view, which wanted the nightmare to end, and the other as a passing inconvenience as it didn't directly affect them. Mrs. Darling was a non-Jew whose life may not have been affected by the war as it affected the narrator and the family. The narrator had lost everything while Mrs. Darling continued to live in her old home in her old neighborhood. Mrs. S represents the essential goodness that is present in every human, and Mrs. Darling represents a malicious version of it. So this is question number 8. Next is, the war is divided into pre-war and post-war times. So you all can think that this is the story, that address is the story after the war. But there are some incidents from pre-war also. So the story begins with the time when the war has ended. So the story begins post-war. Although few things had remained unchanged, lives had changed completely. We come to know that the narrator was a lone survivor of a family after the Second World War. So after the war, she had avoided coming to collect all the belongings of the mother, because they would bring back unpleasant memories, which she had seen trying to avoid. Before the war, we get a picture of the narrator's family where they had a nice house with lots of antique and expensive things. They were a simple family, as shown through the narrator's mother, Mrs. S. Post-war, the narrator was living in a small rented room from whose windows hung black paper, which was used to black out the windows during the bombings. She slept in a bed with a view that took time adjusting to. She was constantly threatened even while sleeping, and the quality of food that she had was poor. But her conditions pre-war was completely opposite. She had a comfortable home, a humble family, and a simple life. Post-war, everything is in the shadow of remembrance of that previous time. Thus, the story very poignantly captures the essential difference that the war brought into the very conscience of people. It was evident after the war, nothing ever returned back to being normal for all. So this is it. This is a contrast, pre-war and post-war. So our last question is, which contains the theme of the story, that explain the main theme. The address is a story of human predicament that follows war. Comment on this. So the war, when survived, leaves its survivals ravaged. Some survive through it and try to start a new life, but some of them remain martyred in that massacre of humanity, even if they are alive, like the girl, like the narrator Maga Mingo herself. Overcoming the atrocities of war and cruelties of leaders who were supposed to protect you isn't something which the average human is equipped to do. However, the narrator here is stuck between the two, the need to overcome and the urge to reminisce. In the address, we observed that the narrator chose the more logical path for a long time and avoided visiting her old neighborhood in order to retrieve the things. But when her conditions improved a bit more, she got a curiosity to get the things. Curiosity got the better of her and she ended up visiting Mrs. Stalling, who was in charge of safekeeping their stuff. Although in the end, the narrator doesn't get to touch in her old things, but she claims that those things lose their value when you see them again without context, as the things were not with the persons whom they were linked to. So the story therefore aptly portrays the oscillating predicament of a war-ravaged human whose present life is completely opposite to their previous and simple life. But sometimes a choice has to be made to forget that life in order to move on and rebuild. And as seen in this case, sometimes we need to remember things one more time in order to get them forever. So this is the story. These are the questions of the address by Maga Mingo, which contains the main theme, post-war human predicament. So this is all about the question answers of the address, students. Please ask for any doubts. Thank you so much.